How you doing? How you doing? How you doing? Bree here with Ginger in the Desert Creations, coming at you with number 4, the final installment with the dried and assembled results of the monochrome in blue acrylic swipe. Let's go paint!
I think I'm going to do one crossy stripes and one chaotic something or other. We'll see. But I'm going to move stuff over so hopefully I don't disturb that one. Yeah, at the same time. Put a generous drag of the silver. Regale blue. I like saying it that way, even if it is wrong. Deep sapphire. Big old blob of deep sapphire there. The pewter. Pewter. And my favorite peacock. Pearl, which we ain't gonna have a whole lot left of. Let's just room right across. That wasn't good. Better but darker. Lot of the black in this one. I guess it's because I've got that edge of black, so if I push it so that it's more silver, for some reason this is not cooperating well. Just too silver. And then when I swipe it again, it's just too black. May not be able to do the other one. Because I don't think I'm going to have the paint. I would have if this one would have cooperated better. Sticky dry paper towel coming to the rescue, maybe. Doesn't have to be dry, I've got my wash bottle here. I don't know how a big stripe of black keeps coming back into the equation. I guess this is pretty weighty though, with saturated paper towel. I do something a little bit unusual? This is Chroma Molten Metals Copper. And it is left over from yesterday. But a nice pop of orange might be what this stupid thing needs. Still gotta fix this bottom though. Probably already too much of that pewter in there, and that's why it looks that drabness. That's not just the black's fault. Come on back to the other way. That got some color variation into it. Let's see if this one sticks out too much if I just use the colors and no black, since I am very out of black. I'm just gonna go nuts. Put all the colors on, swipe them around, and see what we come up with. This is what you call screw it. A lot of silver. I'm going to incorporate copper into both of the middle ones. And the copper is just plain Floetrol, which I'm fine with. Actually, I think I do have some more. Well, I've got some Mont silver. That's not the Pebeo silver, but it's still silver, right? Silver. Oops. That's not nice. I don't want to keep the copper centralized like it is on the bottom one. That is becoming difficult. That's too much copper. We do know that I don't know what I'm doing, right? Just kind of trying to goof off until I like something that comes out of it. But I'm probably going to end up with med before I get there. We come in with the rest of the Montmartre silver. Move your whole table. Sorry about that. This is the Pebeo silver back again. Whoops. Damn it. Don't want to touch that one. So just bow to the pressure and follow the line. starting to like the way this one is developing. I might like this one better if it mellows a little bit more. It's not bad with the lines. They're not perfect because I've messed with that too long, but still doesn't look that bad. So, let's see if I can show you what I'm thinking. Move this over. Move this over. Move this over. So either this all displayed on one board, and the board will likely be painted a very, very, very light blue, almost white, or this one in the center, in the same relative configuration. I haven't decided what I want to do yet.
We'll see what it looks like when they dry.
So here we are. Let's do a little close up. There's that one. I don't know why it doesn't look like it's not focusing now. There we go. Yeah, you're focused. Must be late for you too. There's the other one. Still don't know how I feel about that, but it looks better than I was expecting it to turn out. Here we got one of the side pieces. Here we are with our swipe pouring medium comparison. Etc. I did end up deciding to remove the middle panel, the one that was going to be the vertical stripes, because I didn't feel like it gave me enough variety. And surprisingly enough, I don't even mind that I made one of those angled panels angling the wrong way. But here we have our comparison between the M1 over here, which dried with those big old cells, that bigger laciness. And then the stuff I made with the blues and the coppers, just to kind of break stuff up. And this over here, well, that's my pens, but move out the way. This over here, that is Floetrol, and that is what Floetrol does with metallics and a opaque black base. And it has the much smaller cells and lacing. I kind of do like them both. I kind of like them combined. I think they play well together. If I had to choose one out of the effects that we have here, I would say that Floetrol is the winner. Just because I like the simple stuff that it does. But I do like that big lacing. It has its place too. So, yeah. I don't know. I use both. So, there. Anyway, thanks for watching. That's my monochrome blue that's not so monochrome anymore since I included some copper. That's awkward. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.